Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Star Traders Frontiers. I'm your host, Colors Fade. It's episode 25, and we're in the Valde Belt. We have several missions here, but we're particularly trained on this one, Colony Ruins, which has a six-year time limit. We don't want to wait that long to get to it. We have several missions between here and there, and if we, in fact, want to sort them by length of time, this one is the one that's... It wants us to go all the way back to Cadrino Chaos. In a year and 31 weeks, so that's kind of pressing. Other than that, the main one that we want to go to is in this place called Gaga Pass. So, rah rah, ooh la la. We're going to take off and head over there in that direction, do a few quests, do whatever we encounter along the way. The pox is still going on, and our current pox score is somewhere in like 73 or something like that. I'm not sure if you can actually tell from here. Looking at this, I don't see it. This Derivish blade thing is still on, which is kind of too bad. And then the rumor mill says Crimson Plague galaxy wide. But it doesn't seem to list the score anywhere here, which is kind of a shame. So, Crimson Pox outbreak. Medical wards and hospitals are overflowing, sick and dying, and the Crimson Pox is racing through the population in the Scottsbluff sector. We could sell medical supplies here without concern for trade law or permit, and we will gain reputation with the local faction. So that's the nice part of it. So you can sell things like that. So, before we land over there, before we try to jump again, the smart thing to do, of course, would be to always be looking to see if anybody has that stuff. And if they do, pick it up, and if they don't, just carry on. Buy a cargo, they got biomass. Okay. And actually, I should probably know which systems sell this stuff, but it's a thing I've not memorized, so I just thought I'd check as we went along there. Pyrite! Alrighty, there it is, Exox. Sorsha, listen to me! Do you have anything important to say? Quiet reclamation. So, we've got saving talents. Captain's charisma is a 30. It's a little off screen, it says there. John contains inner influence. Misdirected visit. I hope we can pass that. We do. 214 is what we get paid for that. We got completed that mission, so that's nice. There's a chasing researcher here. Missions. This one goes to the Orion Fisher and then back to two jumps to the Cadrino Chaos, which we kind of have to go back. Again, I don't know if we're going to need these, but what I'm doing basically is picking these up and then trying to use them to help my situation here with the Crimson Pox. I figure we pick them up until our score gets to be 100 and then we just dump them. Take the faction hit. Whatever it ends up being. She's a naval recruiter, and these guys have basic medicines. They have 21 units. Well, they might have more than that, but that's all we can fit in our cargo hold because we can't sell the Terox here. They're illegal. Oh, and we could pay our crew. Alright, so next up, since we're in Catherine's Loop, here's Gaga Pass. Alright, let's go to this wilderness. Work on this situation here. Off we go. Let's see. Bribe. Oh, they're Kadar. Why do I keep doing that? They're Kadar. We don't care about them. We can get fuel in this next system. So onward. Navigate. Alright, let's grab the fuel because this could take a little bit of time. Over here, colony ruins. Damage to the crew. Two crew suffered 19 damage. That's not good. Oh my goodness, more crew suffering. Raw resources. Pirate. Intel records. Still not quite where we want to be. Xeno combat. Uglies. But we get the mission success instead. We found nothing but the slightest signs of where the colony hive's foundations were laid. Lost over 200 years ago. We were not going to find anything useful. But we have uncovered the colony center, which is very valuable information. How? Because it will define the area with which we seek the Exodus pod. What is that exactly? In these more civilized times, the practice has been forgotten. However, during the Exodus, every colony hive was equipped with a cache of Exodus pods. These beacon and record pods were fired off regularly into the void. If a colony ship set down on a world, multiple were shot into orbit. They contained navigational data and records that might help other ships who passed through the space, or could act as a beacon for a colony hive lost in the void. Exactly, Captain. In desperate times, such a pod might become a lost ship's last record, and the Exodus was a desperate time. They were designed to hibernate unless awoken by a signal, built to last. And you think we might find such a pod here? It's worth days or weeks of scanning. The Thriceclaw colony hive sailed with the Spirit of Cydonia until it was lost. It is the last ship to have contact with the Kadar battlecruiser. Its pods could include that priceless navigational data. Must keep exploring to find it. We got paid for that one, though. Which is nice. So we keep exploring. And we repair the ship and gain some fuel. Xeno combat. Well, I think we're going to see it this time. Okay. You're out, Elsa. You're up. Let's go hurt these guys. Doc. Actually, let's do this. Heal that person first. Okay, you, my darling. Plus 4 initiative, plus 25 melee damage, all that stuff. That's really nice. It's offensive, though. Buffs 3 targets with accuracy and critical. Buff yourself with melee defense. That's what I'd like to have early. Okay. Now she's up here. Buffs 3 targets with critical for 3 turns. And restores intimidation. That's nice. Removes all defense buffs yourself with deflection armor, resist debuffs, heals. Let yourself heal. Crippling rifle attack causes somebody to get hurt more. Alright, let's aim for the front guy. Alright, now you're in this situation. What does this do? Melee accuracy, melee damage, armor piercing, minus armor for 4 turns and advances a slot. Not what I'm looking for. You can't do that from that slot. And this is buff yourself with melee defense. Yes, please. Okay. Now she's up here and can think about doing something else. This is blade attack hits 2 targets. Okay. What's she got? She's got 16 left. There's also this. Successful attack buffs yourself with melee defense and more armor. Oh, but she missed. Alright, in that case, what do you got here? Melee accuracy advances 1 slot. Well, if I get moved back, I'm going to hit that. Otherwise, I don't want to retreat a slot. So, moves all buffs to the target. Okay. Doc, you gotta heal thyself. You've got this left. Okay, hold on, let's see. What are these? Minus 2 initiative, minus 3 initiative, and 50% stun. Okay. Removes all debuffs and buffs yourself. I like that. Removes all debuffs and buffs 3 targets. I think I'd rather have this, because it's going to add some critical to me. That helped. Okay, you. From this third position, you can advance a slot. Or show of confidence. This helped buff everybody up front. Okay. Alright. Doc, I think the thing you need to do is heal yourself. Okay, he moved up close. That's great. I need her to hit this thing and advance a slot. I don't want to spend time. Okay, increment buffs. Push this target forward one slot. You can't do it from the front position, though. That's the problem. Okay. They're going to keep pushing us around. I'd rather do that. And this is minus 4 initiative. Bleeding. Plasma damage. Hit causes plasma damage. Hits 2 targets. Okay, because that's what I wanted to do. There we go. You, my darling. Advances one slot. I need to get around that doctor first. I could shoot my gun, but I'm not caring so much about that. Buff yourself with melee accuracy, melee damage. Yes, do it. It's gonna advance me a slot, but okay. Now you've got this, and you can advance. Here, how much? Hold on, what's this do? I know what this does. I'm just trying to think of, is there one that reduces initiative? Removes buffs from the target. He's debuffs, but he's not quite dead. Can be after this, though. Or we could use this one. Hits 2 targets. Yeah, I kind of want to hit 2 targets. Yikes. Darling, hit him with this. He did good. Now we need morale. She's got just darn near every buff on her, doesn't she? Okay. He's dead. You don't have all your buffs on you. Yeah. What's this one? Yeah, plus 4 initiative. Bleeding, armor piercing, critical, advances one slot. Except she's also got herself heal, right? That one returns morale, but that's not the same thing. Heals, buff yourself. Okay. Now. This will make him do less damage. Oh, but it missed. Oh, but it missed. You've got two initiative left, darling. This will make you hit harder, but it's going to cost 12, so that'll put you in the penalty. This cost 12, it'll put you in the penalty. This cost 8, it'll move you an advanced slot. It causes minus 4 initiative, we don't really need to do that right now. That hits two targets, and it doesn't really matter if it hits two targets. So I think... And then this is what? This is also 12? Let's do this. Same thing with you. What do you got? This is 8 total, and it retreats one slot, and it buffs yourself. Buffs are running out this turn. Alright, back to here. On the front line. Let's do this. You have that one down. So we get poison this son of a bitch. Doc? Now you can really smack him around here. Second slot. This advances you. Moves you up. Minus 2 initiative for him. Might kill. Close. Well, let's hold on here. These do what? Minus 4 initiative? It's going to kill him. If it hits him. There we go. We got through that pretty well. Okay. That worked out well in our favor. Mission success. As we hoped, the survey team has found the pod signal. Time to break out the Lux. Almost. Where is it? It's buried deep under the earth. Take some time to dig up. You'll be paid handsomely for the time, Captain. Bring me that pod. A few days of hard labor and the pod is in our possession. It is remarkably well made and only suffered minor damage over the centuries. We must return to John Caton with both Vilana and the pod. Well, excellent for us then. There's some stuff in the stash, but biomass, who cares about that? That's just some poo. That's all that is. Okay. A private cruiser has been waiting in orbit. They're closing. Greetings from the void, Captain. Closing fast, Captain. Let's talk, Captain. I'm well aware who you are working for and that the explorer Vilana is on your ship. Close the channel and keep evading, Navigator. Vilana, want to explain? I know her. She's one of the pirates freelancing for Prince Yalto. And who is that? John's work is too important not to attract all the wrong kind of attention. The Thulan Prince Yalto is always hounding us. Captain Slain is one of his wolves. I see. So this is what John meant when he said occasional pirates and rogues. I'm not impressed. Officer, open the channel. Captain Slain, it seems you intend to interfere with our lawful business here in the void. The void has no mercy. Law is written by the victor. Steal your engines and turn over Vilana and you're fine to us. No one will be harmed. And Prince Yalta will pay you for your time. 100,000 credits. That might have meant something when I was a new captain. It means nothing now. Shaylon's grave. Why didn't you warn us, Vilana? I'm sorry. John runs this operation. He made the call. Captain, we can't hand her over. Don't trust this pirate's gun. If we betray Vilana to the Prince Yalta, I can see it in Elsa's eyes. She will quit her post. You'll have to prove your threats are more than words. Then you leave us no choice, Captain. Engage. Oh, honey. You don't even know what you're up against yet, do you? Okay. Well, you will soon. Oh, look at this. I sense a buttocks whipping about to happen here. Pirate scum. Oh, please twitch me. Yes. Twitch me close. Twitch me close, tiny dancer. Let's see what I wanted to hit them with. Oh, yeah, minus accuracy. That'd be great. Oh, we're still in this position, though. So let's do this instead. Defense. They want to twitch close? Let them twitch close. do mist. Uh oh, couldn't move though. That's no good. In that case, we will twitch again. And they're going to come aboard, which is totally fine, because guess what? Guess what? You guys really want to waste four people on me? Four of the crew you sent aboard. About to get hammered. Okay. Oh, Doc, let's take him in. Let's kill the good doctor. Just shoot him, Doc. No heals for you. Too bad. Okay. We probably don't even need to run through buffs for these guys, but what the heck. Alright, now you want to stabby stabby? Hits two targets. Just gonna shoot at my good doctor. See what you think about that. Crippling rifle attack causes bleeding. That's Xeno only, and this is Xeno only, and this is a bunch of stuff. Knocks target back one slot. Don't really care about that. I'd rather shoot somebody and buff myself. Not that one. There's this. More buffs. How'd you like that? Oh, she's gonna kill me now. Discipline. Well, I have just the thing for you. It's called poison. Oh, you're hurting. Captain, you may want to back off. Because now, here comes the real pain. Enemy boarding party, not successful. Plus, to hit craft. Crit damage. Oh, there were some big crits there. And now he's thinking about backing up. It's like, that's not... That wasn't part of the plan. I was not wanting to do that, he said. Oops. Oopsies. Should retreat, punk. I don't even need to really do anything here. Just recycle weapons and hit some more defense for the heck of it. There you go. There's shish kebab. Into the void they go. It is true John Caton failed to warn us about you, Captain Slane, but Prince Yalto should have given you fair warning about us. Proper response. I like that response, by the way. It's kind of awesome. Okay. Who leveled up? A commander leveled up. One of my many commanders. Not crew combat. Let's see. Contacts, hidden traits, don't care about. Mutiny, I try to find myself, never in. You can get this speech thing again or a new crew member in case that becomes necessary later. Alright. So we did that, and now we have Dragon Disc, and then we have to come back down. Like, well, it'd probably be easier to go to Catherine's Loop first. So let's do that. Catherine's Loop. Oh, but before we do anything, let's do this. Let's heal our crew that got hurt. All one of them. Captain Slane. Hope you enjoy your grave. Excellent. Onward. Very nice. Colony Ruins. Security checkpoint. We got Lucky John, your lead on the Thrice Claw, hit pay dirt. Should have the Zenran Exodus pod. It's damaged, but with some careful prying, we should be able to get free of its record banks. You've proven invaluable, Captain. You did more than help find the pod. I see. So Yalto's pirates were waiting and watching. And if you're standing here, that means our valiant captain and crew bested them. You should have warned us. I'm sure I mentioned that there were pirates interested in my work. That's true, but not helpful. There is a Thulan prince who has been hunting and hounding you long enough that your operatives know each other by name. If there are any other secrets you'd like to play coy about, don't. Let me offer you a well-earned bonus as an apology, Captain. John Caton has gifted us with a rare piece of gear that one of our officers could use, a Koldarian Exo. We have work to do, he says. We got paid a little bit of coin for that. What does the Koldarian Exo do? I have no idea, but I'm going to find out. Piece of gear. It's plus 2 quickness, plus 2 fortitude, plus 2 strength, and plus 50 armor piercing. Oh, nice. Not too bad. I don't know who I put that on, but it's alright. Okay, Mr. Researcher. What did you learn about the spirit of Cardonia? Pod has the records we hoped, but the Thrice Claw split from the spirit of Cardonia earlier than we expected. The colony hive was having void reactor problems, and the spirit went on to try to catch another splinter of the fleet. It's an invaluable look into the Exodus. The main fleet was falling apart, and more ships were lost. Ships began to abandon each other. And it is the last recorded comms with a legendary battlecruiser that is about to blink out of our knowledge. That doesn't help us locate the spirit? It may still. The extracted trajectory and navigational intel has identified a host of possible destinations. I am pulling on a wide network of Kadar agents to check many of the sites, but I need all the help I can get. I would assign 3 to you. They are not near, but you can check them in any order you wish. I hope you will join this Galactic Survey team to help us find the spirit of Cardonia. All right. We will join your survey team and hunt the legend. Alright. We have a story mission, he says. This one. Tracking the spirit, the Juhiti Spiral, is close by. Wow. That's actually not that far. It's right there. So before we go up to Dragon Disc, we might want to go over here then. Well then, let's do it. Off we go into the wild black yonder. Into the void. Somebody leveled up. An officer, a military officer. What have we got? After successful boarding, you can demand for a quick surrender, causing some morale damage. That's always nice. Reroll 5 cards and draw a new hand. We know that wouldn't help us very much. Buffs the ship with boarding accuracy, standard damage, and 10 critical for the next 3 turns. Restores command skill versus morale. That's not too bad. He's got a better one up here. 10 plus 10 boarding, plus 10 accuracy, plus 20 standard damage, plus 10 defense up here instead of critical. Purges ship of crippling effects and restores command skill worth of morale to the crew. Let me grab that one instead. It's almost the same. The other one gave you plus more standard damage and no defense, so. And didn't purge the ship of any crippling effects. Well, here we go. Let's see about this. Smuggler. The klaxon is warning us. It's blaring. Hot diggity dog. Okay, let's pay for some fuel. Orbit. land. Tracking the spirit. What do we see here? Success! While we may never find the spirit, our job is to leave no stone unturned. There's nothing here. We must head to the next site. Oh, well, bummer for you guys. Nothing here. Okay. Well. Catherine Loop. Next site is in the system where we're at. He said we can do these in any order, but it looks like I'm just going to go geographic. Which would technically be in any order that we wanted it to. Let's go check this one. Send me in, Captain Doc. You get to go on all of them. What are you talking about? You're always going. Months lost. I don't think so. Don't hit me with that. Get out of here with that noise. Okay. Oh, I thought we were going to get a chance there. Months lost. Bye-bye. Go away. What do we have here? Let's hope some of the other expeditions had better luck. Another dead end. Well. Central Plaza. I think we're done with the pox is what this means. Citizens. The Chase and doctors have delivered our people from this plague, so we don't have to worry about any of those plague missions anymore. So we finished out, like good politicians, the United Coalition claimed as much of the responsibility as they could for the cure, even though it was the Chase and doctors. In the end, what matters is the plague is ending. So that's over. We didn't quite get there. If we would have focused on it sooner, we would have, because our score was pretty high. But I've already finished that achievement, so I'm not going to cry over that one. But I am going to level up this person, whoever it is. Oh, it's this one. Our assassin. Okay, so what'd she get? 14 blades. So I think the only thing that they've got at level 15, they're done getting talents. But you add this and it keeps adding to her blade skills. So I think. Did it not? Rank 17 grants plus 1 blades for a total of 15 blades. Yes, plus 9 evasion. And the more evasion, the better. So... Oh, and she still has more. She has one talent here. Okay. I don't care about the engineering ones. So, what are we going to do? There's a bunch of good stuff still left to take for this character. She's got some stealth skills. This engages stealth mode, and so does this bomb. So there are things we can do with stealth mode, but I'm looking at the more basic stuff. Like this. Even though it costs 1.5 weapon initiative to use. It buffs yourself with 25% melee accuracy, plus 10% melee damage, armor piercing, and melee defense. So it's kind of ideal against the Xenos because they do so much melee damage. And you have to get accurate. That was the problem that I found the first time I tried to take on the Jaeda Xenos, is that I had a blade person up front that could stand up to it defensively somewhat, but they couldn't hit anything, and that was a real bummer. So I want things that give me the best of both worlds, offense and defense, attack accuracy and defense. So 20% mission chance success, we did it. Our tour has not been in vain. We have removed many possibilities from the list. The spirit of Cydonia did not pass this way. Finding a legend was never going to be easy. We must return to him and see if there has been better luck. Okay. So, up here, this one, Far Fallen Rim, is a long way away. I'm going to cancel that mission and lose that. This thing, yes, make it go away, because we did that a long time ago and finished it. This one, Catherine's Loop. We have to go drop this person off. This is Dragon Disc. These are four-year, two-year. Orion Fisher. This is all the way over in Carrick Pillars. So this is Catherine's Loop. Let's go there and drop that off. But let's get gas first. fuel. And she picked up another one. The Blade Dancer. So this character also gets another one. Let's look these over. So again, many good choices that I like here. Slashing Recruit is nice because it buffs yourself with melee defense and range defense and plus 10% armor. I like that. Blade Attack with armor piercing critical and removes buffs from the target. We're also going to need to do that. So removes all in crew combat, removes all debuffs, restores two targets worth of the morale. I don't care so much about that. And this attacks two targets and it buffs yourself, but they're smaller buffs. But although 25 pretty kill is nice, but it gives you minus 15% melee defense and minus 15% range defense. And I don't want to do anything like that against the Xenos. I don't want to subtract anything. So I like this slashing retreat. That's what I'm going to pick. I don't want any penalties against the Xenos, and I want as many buffs as I can get. And this is a pirate. I'm not going to surrender to looting, so we'll just skip off the void. Get fuel here. And we can probably sell. So we could sell all of these. We'd take them for a loss. I just want to sell them. I just want to get them out of there. And can I sell these illegal? Darn it. Still makes no sense to me. It makes even less sense in the black market. It's just like, what? Tracking security checkpoint. Found nothing, John. Don't ever let that discourage you. We're searching for a legendary speck in a galactic spy spell. If I gave up every time I came up with a miss, I'd have quit on my first hunt. And there is better news from some of the other expeditions. 3 cent word of possibly promising leads. One of the three may need Shaelin more than the others. The promising site missed its second check-in. Oh, could be Xenos. Could be Yalto. Give us the coordinates. We're on our way. Yep. We will. So, we get paid for that, 33k, not much, kind of peanuts, but we get this story mission. Alright, we must scour the way there. Alright, specialist gear. I never ever too much look at, well, yeah, we got minus Kadar rep, so he's going to be like, nope, never, uh-uh. Alright. Well then. What we'll do here is take a look at how much time we have. So, seeking the forest flora, expedition interrupted, expedition astray, plague corpse. Where's the... Oh, I see. So we got to take somebody with us for this. All right. So we have somebody on our ship. Oh, yes, we do. Okay. So that's it. It's 6 years, which gives us a lot of time. So the thing that's going to go down right now soon is this one that needs us to go drop it off at Garrick Pillar. So we're going to do that. We're going to go try to take care of, clear some of these others off and get paid for them instead of just letting them disappear and taking the negative faction. So we will run over to this east, southeast end of the galaxy and start there and work our way back. The spirit of Kadonia. And now we gotta go through Valde Belt. Yeah. Why would anyone ever want to quit this ship? You're right, we don't have mutinies. Doesn't happen. In general, my people stay alive, so that's good. Captain, I need a moment of your time. I've seen you hawking your story at every ship in the starport. It's urgent, I will pay very well, but the risk has been too much for others. My most expedition went missing in the wilderness. I had set up a permanent camp because of a massive discovery. The empty spores of a never-before-seen xenotype. Any surprises we may have missed in their latest update? The spores were abandoned, but they've gone silent. You can tell yourself there were no xeno there if you like. I have no qualms admitting that they are most likely dead, but their corpses mark a very important and very rewarding dig site. I'm offering you the coordinates. Go there, kill whatever killed them, and let's get rich together. Explorer Ito is offering a mission to explore wilderness and then face some unknown xeno threat, but he's offering 300,000 at least 25 of the artifacts. Alright, we'll kill whatever it takes to uncover such a discovery. Expedition discovery mission in his mission list. So, he gives us this. It's a one-way mission to Dagon's Run, and this is where we're going to start to run into the new Xenos, I think. So, good time for us. Can you get us into the black market? Hostile security patrol. Don't confiscate my types. I'm just trying to sell four things. Oh, you can't sell them here. See, that's the part that I think is really dumb. It's a black market. That is the definition of black market. Just like the definition of pirate is somebody who doesn't fly anybody else's flag. So, there's design choices in this game that I just don't agree with. The black market should accept anything. You want to create risk of going to the black market? That makes all the sense in the world. Go for it. Do it. But I should be able to sell those illegal goods at any black market. Otherwise, it's not really a black market. It's just a permit-restricted market. And that's not the same thing. So here we are, Gaddick Pillars, and there's a pirate, but see, it's not really a pirate. See, if you're flying somebody else's flag, technically I believe you're a privateer. Alright, I'm going to read this because it's really interesting. I think this strikes to the heart of my point about pirates versus privateer. The music's going to go out, but listen to this. A privateer was a pirate with papers. As the name suggests, privateers were private individuals commissioned by governments to carry out quasi-military activities. They would sail in privately owned armed ships, robbing merchant vessels and pillaging settlements belonging to a rival country. The most famous of all privateers is probably English Admiral Francis Drake, who made a fortune plundering Spanish settlements in the Americas after being granted a privateering commission by Elizabeth I in 1572. So, that's the thing. Like, pirates did pirating stuff. Pirates plundered and killed and raped and pillaged via boat, and they didn't fly for anybody. They were private individuals that did not have papers. Privateers had papers. This game gets it all wrong. It calls things pirates and they fly for these other flags. It's like, no. And then they have independent. That's what a pirate is independent. They really should name them to privateers, is what they should do. That's the first big change that they should make. Just rename them. They don't have to change anything else in the game other than rename the pirates privateers. Because then they can fly the Kedar flag, or they can fly the Steel Song flag, and we would understand, oh yeah, they're kind of like a pirate, but they fly. They have papers. They fly for that guy. They fly for that government. And then the second thing they have to change is the black market. It should just accept everything. It's a black market. And it's stuff like that that just drives me nuts. And it's stuff like that that keeps me, that prevents me from wholeheartedly 100% endorsing this game and saying, yes, it's one of the best games I've ever played and everybody should buy it. I'm really hesitant to say that because there are still things in this game that irk me. This person is an independent and a pirate. This is the only time it's correct. If you want it to say pirate, they should always be independent faction. That would be accurate, and I could live with that. I couldn't just live with it. I'd say it's cool. It's correct. Like Ralphie May said, I'm not trying to be politically correct. I'm just trying to be just correct. You know? It's like that's... So, stuff like that just drives me nuts. And even if you want to get really nitpicky about, if you want to go down and do the whole pirate thing and say, yeah, but there were pirates that flew their pirate flag and some government's flag or whatever. My argument to you is going to be, use common sense. If you ask the average person on the street what a pirate is and what flag they fly, they'd say, well, they're independent. They fly the black flag with the skull and crossbones on it. Don't make it more complicated than it is. Do the normal thing. This honest merchant, smuggler, Cheka, I'm a smuggler through and through. Honest merchants don't make real money. How exactly are we going to get rich together? I've been listening to Military Chatter for a while. Certainly by now you've heard of the great Jaeda brood that has swarmed out of the Elysian core. Jaeda were wiped out. Yeah, they're back. What matters is they're back. Of course, I knew they were coming a while ago. It was all whispers before. Now it's a roar. All the fighting happened in the Elysian core back then. Well, that's where it started this time, too. And what they need there is weapons. Lots and lots of weapons. You're in luck, because I've been stockpiling weapons. Now I need a reliable trader to pick them up and ship them to the core and neighboring quadrants. To help in the battle against the Jaeda? Curse the pit. What? No, to make money. You and your honest merchantry. What do you say, Captain? I'm offering a good covet of every sale. Check the starport system shows Cheka's claims to be true. Jaeda sightings are all over the place. Okay, so we're not getting involved. Oh, without a protector, the mob wastes no time in dragging the doomed xenologist away. During this area, we can expect to encounter the cursed Jaeda void slugs anywhere, but must be most careful in the affected quadrants. If we're willing to fight them, the rewards are sure to be as high as the risks. Just after the end of the Exodus, the first Jaeda brood threatened to wipe out the Farfallen Rim. Shaelin and much of the Templar fleet were destroyed in a desperate attempt to stop them. The Alzian core was the battleground, and it's littered with the remnants of that war and host Shaelin's tomb world. Now, more than 200 years later, another brood is awoken. Okay, well, that sounds fun. So, we are in the thick of the whole Jaeda thing. We've gathered intel. Their ships are extremely powerful, and they need to be wary to fight them. They are notoriously carriers, and they fight with swarms of interdictors, bombers, and boarding craft. We should not attempt to engage your ships until we've made some upgrades to ours. We should consider ship components that help shoot down or avoid enemy craft, such as sea tech, interceptor systems, rail track guidance matrix, and pilot assist modules. Or we may want to ensure we have our own launch bays ready so we can meet them craft to craft. We should also be sure to retrain some of our crew to prepare for more anti-aircraft talents. Finally, crew officers with gun deck, boss job, or specialists in finding carriers, and we should be sure to have one or more aboard. If we face the Jaeda without preparation and modified strategy, we're likely to overwhelm us. That's a curious thing. So let's take a look at that. The ship. So we're way over here on gunnery. You can see. So this is going to be interesting. We probably need to adjust things here. Let's go back and look. We have one passenger that we're ferrying around and then three prisoners. Let's look at how we can adjust our ship. We have 4.9 million. So I think I want to try to add some more guns. All right, so the first thing I did was I put a cargo crew over here taking off one of these armored bulkheads. Excuse me. An armored bulkhead 4. Because there is no armored bulkhead 5 here. And that drops us down from 60% shield to 58%. It drops us down from a shield of 50 to 47 is what that did. But it gives me the cargo over here so I can free up a medium slot over here with this storage hold in a medium slot with the prisoners, because we don't have any prisoners right now and none of the missions that we have prisoners in them. I might have to change my mind about that later. But that would allow us to add two weapons. We still have this battle barracks and two officers' quarters over here. We also have this passenger thing, but we can swap that over for a prison later when we get done with the passenger we're carrying around. The question is what weapons to put on this thing. Now, obviously, we have We have these two things which fire at 4 RP apiece, 4 reactor points apiece. And this, which also fires at 2 reactor points apiece, it's a level 8 lance. So that's 10 full reactor points at position number 2, provided that we don't get any negatives on it. So obviously I think we need something for while we're moving up. And that would mean something that fires two weapons that fire for 3 reactor points apiece, so you could spend 4 reactor points moving and 6 shooting. But the question is what to really shoot. And your two options are basically this. Your two options are the missiles, which you could see there's a level 7 missile here with a 14 accuracy at an optimal range of 4. Strikes with 40% critical and only a 25% crippling chance. It does radiation damage. And it does up to 270 straight up damage. And it has a 40% chance to hit craft, which is nice. Otherwise, you're moving on to these torpedoes, which have a much lower percent chance to hit craft, do a lot less damage, and do some void damage. And I'm thinking, no, they have a higher cripple chance. And cripple is basically, my understanding is, it's the ability to add a debuff to the ship. So those little icons that show up that say, like, you know, -1 reactor points and a bunch of stuff, a debuff. I think being able to hit I think these are probably better because the chance to hit the craft, plus 14 accuracy at an optimal range of 4, it's going to fire. The other ones only have an optimal range. You could see, let's go back and look at them. Optimal range of 5, and you can fire them at 5 and 4, and then you're done. So these fire all the way in. So I'm thinking these. This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to do that. I'm going to get rid of the prisoner one. Go to weapons. I'm going to get this thing. I'm going to get 2 of these guys. That's going to help us have firepower on the way in. That also takes, you know, we had like 400 gunnery. Well, now it takes some of those away because we need them, you know. So we've got extra navigation. I want to know what a gun deck boss. Why is he so special? Gunnery, intimidate, repair. We don't have any free slots, of course. We have more than enough navigation and kind of more than enough electronics and ship ops. So if we wanted to, we could go to our crew and we could say, okay, give me, how many navigators do I have? These are all my pilots. Here's my navigators. I got 4 navigators. I can afford to get rid of 1 of you. So skip off the void, flash charge. She's got skip off the void. She does not have flash charge. She's the only one that doesn't have flash charge. So what's her... And she's got nothing else special going on here. She's got some nice stuff if she was going to be a shooter, but she doesn't. So I'm going to dismiss her. All right, because I don't want to lose. And then it leaves me with 3 skip offs of the voids and 3 flash charges, because she didn't have flash charge, and that's a problem. So now we can go in and say, okay, gun deck boss, is that really super important? Let's see. What's he give us? Gunnery, rifles, intimidate. Let's see about his skills then. I know they're telling us we needed gun deck bosses. Let's see if that's true. So I need the gun deck boss. Where is it? Oh, it's gonna be, it should just be new person, right? Yep. Okay, I like your uniform, but if you're gonna be a gun deck boss, then we have to get you in the right uniform that looks like the other gun. There we go. So I don't know if you actually really need this character on or not. Let's see what kind of... So there's Deadeye, buff ship with 35% to hit craft and 15 standard damage for the next 3 turns. So that's a fair one right off the bat. Debuffs launched enemy craft with minus 10 boarding, minus 30 hit chance, and a minus 25% standard damage for the next 4 turns. Okay. Purges your ship's crew of any crippling effects and restores gunnery skill worth of morale. Extreme targeting lock forces 1 enemy craft to immediately land. I've taken this before and it's fun, but it when they're launching 4 or 5 craft, I'm not sure how useful it is. Debuff launch enemy craft with minus 1 initiative, minus 10% standard damage, and minus 25 craft evasion for the next 4 turns. Huh. Okay, the minus one initiative will help you shoot them down first. Okay. And he's got ship ops test. Well, I'll grab that one. And let's see what else they have there. All the way up to level 8. I'll grab that. If there are a lot of ships, that could end up being useful. Only one. I got one more point to spend. Okay. I don't think any of these buffs are going to be super important, but we'll find out. Alright, and that's probably going to conclude this episode. It's been a long time. Jita Awakening, four jumps, the local military, navy. They need help. So, that's where we're at with that. And here's our ship. We have these big old missiles on there now. Along with our up-close stuff. We'll go see if we can do this Jaida stuff. It's like the last thing. Thanks for watching, everybody. As always, if you dig it, give it a thumbs up. Leave your questions, comments below. Subscribe to the channel. I'll see y'all next time.